Yeah, it's a great day.
Have a seat right here.
Hi, Paul. I'm Catherine Reed. I'm an agent with the Kentucky Bureau of Investigation. This is Detective Tom Nischke with the Campbell County Police Department. And they read you your rights earlier, and you know that you're under arrest. You're in custody. You're not going home tonight. But we need to take care of some housekeeping issues first. But he did go over your rights, correct?
Mm-hmm.
And you understood them?
Yeah.
Can I have your home address first? How long have you lived there?
Since January. I'm rooming with my sister right now.
So is it her home?
Yeah.
Okay. Do you share the whole house, or do you live in a part of it?
I share the house. I sleep in the basement.
You sleep in the basement?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So is that where you do most of your living?
Yeah.
The majority of it? Does she come into the basement where you stay?
Yeah, she has a craft room down there.
But is it separated? Is it one just big basement? How's that?
Yeah, it's separated by a door. I have a back bedroom.
Okay, so there's a wall and a door that makes it distinct from her craft room?
Yeah.
Okay. We need to get a phone number for you. And you said you've been there since January?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And you said you lived in a house in Monroe?
Yeah.
Okay. Like in a subdivision, or is it? I've never been to Monroe, I couldn't tell.
It's a subdivision in Monroe.
Okay. Is it like a one-story, two-story house? Or
one-story ranch.
One-story ranch.
You got all that?
Yeah.
So we're good to go. You have an emergency contact?
Yeah, my sister.
You want to give us her name and number?
Yeah.
Okay.
So you no longer live at this on your driver's license?
Not since the end of 05.
Okay. Pete, you know that you're under arrest. We've already established that. And I'd like to talk to you about your situation.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sure that you have a side of your story. And I know what I've seen. I know what I've read about. I've looked at the chat logs. And you came to Highland Heights to meet someone. If you would like to talk to me about that, I would like to hear about it. But that's completely up to you.
Mm-hmm. I can fill you in.
Okay.
When I originally decided to do that, I was having second thoughts, and I had a feeling. Guess because I watched too many police shows.
Mm-hmm. Now you said when you originally decided to do that, what are we talking about?
Well, I originally decided to make the trip around 5 or 6 this evening. So I went, I ran an errand, and I talked myself out of going, went back home. And I hooked up with her again.
Online?
Yeah.
Hooked up with who?
Kylie. Yeah. And I decided to, I don't know why I decided to follow through on it.
Okay.
I should have. I've never done that before.
You've never met anybody in a chat room?
Well, I've met women in chat rooms, but you know, I have friends in the chat rooms who are my age or a little younger, but not that young.
Not that young, yeah. Being 13.
Right, or under 20. But they're all friends. And you know that we've all I've done is talk to them. I've exchanged with a few of them. I've exchanged phone numbers, and we've been talking on and off for months. Sometimes I don't go into the chat room for a couple of days or a week because I'm busy and tired. On the weekends, sometimes I like to just relax and get on and chat with the friends of mine who are on there.
So where are you when you chat?
In my room.
At home?
Mm-hmm.
The address you gave us?
Yeah.
In the basement?
Mm-hmm.
Do you have one PC, two?
One.
Okay. You have a webcam?
Mm-hmm.
Anything else that you use, like a PDA or Trio,
no.
So that you can stay connected? Everybody's connected these days. So.
Just the cam and the computer.
Okay. So is it a PC or a laptop?
PC.
Okay. And when you started... do you have, like, go through, like, Yahoo to chat, or what do you go through to chat? I mean, what do you go through to chat?
Well, I go on a MySpace chat room.
MySpace
chat room. The Ohio MySpace chat room. That's where I've been recently.
Okay. Is that where you met Callie?
Mm-hmm.
Tell me how you found her.
Tell you the truth, I'm not really sure. All I know is that I went into the Ohio chat room one night and somehow we just struck up a conversation and we exchanged instant messenger IDs. I think well, we didn't chat in private until we went into the Yahoo Instant Messenger. And then exchanged information. You know, gave her my name and age. She seemed okay with it. As I said, I've never chatted with anyone in their 20s.
But this time you were okay with her being 13?
Yeah, it was just first it was regular chatting. We didn't really get how can I put that? We didn't really get involved in special chats.
Mm-hmm.
She mentioned that she was with a boy 2 years older than she was, and told me how that went.
You asked her how that went.
Mm-hmm. off the top of my head, I don't know the specifics. All I know is, you know, I asked her how it went and how she liked it and what all they did together. And I just don't know what made me want to follow through on it. As I said, I left the house once and changed my mind.
Mm-hmm.
And kind of wish I stayed with my gut feeling, you know.
Yeah. So what did you all talk about before you planned on coming over to visit?
What did we all talk about?
You had mentioned about special talk.
Yeah. You said that you didn't really have special chat in the beginning. What's special chat?
Well, what I considered special chats is cybering.
Pretending?
Mm-hmm.
Role playing?
Yeah.
So did you have any of those early on?
No. Just not to my knowledge.
Okay. What about before you came over?
When we set it back up, I basically asked her to wear a skirt. She told me when we originally decided to meet, we were going to meet at the bowling alley across the street, and she told me what she was going to wear, told her what I was going to wear.
Now, there was a little more conversation than that prior to determining where you were going to meet about kissing and hugging.
I was mentioning to her that I'm romantic, I'm compassionate. Or I wouldn't mind kissing her. It's something I've never done.
It went beyond that as well.
Yeah. I don't remember what I said, to tell you the truth.
Do you chat a lot?
Do I chat a lot?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, with women my own age or in the neighborhood.
So you have a lot of cyber chat where you role play and you talk about sex.
Yeah, with women over 25.
Well, let's talk about specifically what you said to her, since you don't remember.
We just need some clarification. That's all we're looking for is, and I think you're being honest with us. And that's all we're looking for.
Trying to be.
And, you know,
I just want to understand, you know, where we were going with this.
I don't.
You know, and if you can explain it for me, then, you know, it makes things, I'm cool with it, he's cool with it.
I'm not saying I've never chatted before, you know, that's a given.
Yeah.
But I've never chatted with anyone under, I'll say 20 to be safe,
okay.
You know. Most of the women I meet are in their 30s and 40s. And it's just, you know, fun chat.
Well, let's talk about this real quick.
What screen name do you go by?
In Yahoo or in MySpace?
Both.
MySpace is Paul.
Is Paul?
Yeah, that's what my MySpace ID is.
Paul, just P-A-U-L?
Yeah. Okay. In the Yahoo chat, or in the Yahoo Instant Messenger, it's PWood11. But with an underscore between Pete and Wood.
This here, this chat, that's you?
Yes.
Okay. And this is the person you were talking with?
Yes.
Kylie, K-Y-L-E-E-L-E-E?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so you recognize that?
Yeah.
And do you remember when you started chatting with Kylie?
Originally?
Yeah.
Probably in 1 to 2 weeks.
Do you usually talk to somebody that long?
That long?
I mean, yeah, over that amount of time, 2 weeks?
Yeah.
Okay.
Some of my friends I chat with almost every night.
So you consider her a friend?
Yeah, I guess.
You talk about in your chat that you're a lonely guy. What's that about?
Well,
You said you've been living with your sister since January.
Yeah.
So,
well,
bring me up to that point.
Okay, I was married in 01. Married for 4 years. We separated. She moved back in with her family. I moved to Westchester. And then I've lived there for a year. And then January of this year, I moved in with my sister.
Mm-hmm.
My wife and I were very close for two of the 4 years. And we started drifting apart. And we're still friends, but we decided to separate. I'm in the middle of a divorce. I'm in the middle of filing for a divorce.
You filed?
Yeah. I'm going to file. I've got the paperwork already.
So you're separated, actually.
Mm-hmm. We've been separated a little over a year. But we're still friends. We still see each other.
Sounds like you're in between relationships.
Basically.
Okay. Specifically, you talked to Kylie about... And you say special chat with you here on the phone while we're both alone. I'd love us to make each other feel good because I'm lonely tonight. Where were you going with
that? Well, basically a romantic chat.
Okay. Do you recall having this conversation?
Not word for word, but yes.
Okay, tell me about it.
I just suggested that... we could get together and cuddle on the couch, watch movies or watch TV. I've told her on a few occasions that that I am kind of lonely and I don't have many friends. That's why I go into the chat rooms.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, I thought we could keep each other company.
You think you would have wanted more?
I don't know.
I mean, you're lonely, I understand. And a lot of things are on your mind. Divorce, separation. Those are natural feelings. Okay. I understand. Do you think once you got up here, cuddling and being together, watching movies, you think there could have been a point where possibly it could have went further?
Well, I would try to draw the line at cuddling.
In your chat, you specifically told her that you'd like to have oral sex.
So it probably would have went a little bit further.
A little bit, yeah.
Yeah.
And you graphically talked about how you would do that in her breasts. You talked about staying the night. You talked about her being sexy in her nightgown. That you'd be rubbing her thighs. Massaging and kissing her breasts. And then you talked to her about if she had ever gone down on a guy, the guy that she had been with. And then you talk about that this aroused you, that you were ready to masturbate, to ejaculate from the conversation. So you did expect to have something happen when you went to the house?
Yeah, but I don't know what would have happened. I would have just played it by ear.
But your intention was to have sex tonight, or oral sex?
If it went that far, yeah.
Okay.
Did you bring anything with you? Anything special with you? Bring any movies or anything with you tonight?
No. Okay. Just that bag of pop.
Okay, bag of pop. Was that for you? Or did she mention you to bring that? Or?
No, it was for me.
Okay.
So were you going to stay the night?
No, I wasn't.
No?
No. I had made my mind up to not stay the night.
Okay. What made you change your mind about that? In the chat, you indicated that you would spend the night.
Yeah. Well, I was thinking about it coming down here, and I'm actively involved in my church, and I have obligations to them.
So that would have made the difference. You could have came down here and had sex with her, but as long as you didn't stay the night, it was okay.
Well, I wasn't planning to spend the night, because I had plans for tomorrow anyway.
To go to church?
Mm-hmm.
Is there any... on your computer, I know you chat a lot, and you said nobody under 20. If that was ever looked at, would there be anybody else around the age of 13, 14 on there that you chatted with, if somebody looked at it?
There's a few around 15.
Okay. And have you ever tried to meet them?
No.
How long ago was that?
How long ago did I meet him?
Yeah.
At least a year.
Okay. And what'd you guys talk about?
Just normal stuff, sports, school, activities.
Did you get into a little bit of the cybering too?
Not with most of them.
But you did with some of them.
With some. It was the same type of talk that you had here with Kylie. I think it's helps, but
basically the same, yeah.
Okay. On your computer, at your place there isn't any type of pictures of minors or anything on there, is there?
Not that I'm aware of.
Okay. Do you visit any type of, barely legal or anything like that,
mm-hmm.
underage, any type of websites or anything like that you're aware of?
No.
Okay, so nothing like that would be on there?
Mm-hmm.
Let's see.
What about, you said you had a webcam. Have you ever exchanged any explicit photographs or any... pictures of you masturbating or while you're cybering? Have a more interactive situation where you can see them and they can see you?
Not with minors.
But it may be on your computer.
I'm not sure. I
photographs
understand.
Of you through the web?
It might be. I don't know. All I know about that webcam is that it's just a live feed.
Okay.
Doesn't save any still pictures.
Okay.
But have you exposed yourself? I mean, genitalia or anything?
Not
like
to minors.
Okay, not to minors, okay.
No.
Have you ever sent any pornographic pictures to other adults?
To other adults, yeah.
Yeah.
You know, the other friends of mine.
Okay. Are these men, women?
It's women.
Okay. So you term them as friends?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. What sets them aside from someone who you may be interested in having a relationship, or are you interested in all at any given time?
I am interested in one specifically for a potential relationship. She lives in Oklahoma, and we basically talk every night, not online, but we talk every night. We've chatted on her nights off.
Mm-hmm. In this particular chat with Kylie, there you referred to another person that you were chatting with. Do you remember who that was?
Yeah, she's 19. Her name is Brenda.
Is that her screen name, or is that her name that she's?
Well, I believe it's her name, because she also uses it as her screen name.
Just Brenda,
mm-hmm.
No numbers or.
No.
And that's a 19-year-old you were talking about.
Yeah.
Okay. From Oklahoma.
No. That one is a 47-year-old.
Okay.
So you don't discriminate as far as how old or young they are?
No.
I'm going to be right back. I'll step up for a second.
Is there a chance I can get a glass of water?
Yeah, I'll take care of that for you in a few minutes. Go ahead.
Well, I'm just wanting to know what's going to happen from here.
Well, at this point, we're going to write up your citation, and we're going to get you transported to the local jail. And then they'll process you there, and then you'll have an arraignment, and they'll set your bail. I don't know, that it may be Monday before that happens or later. So you're going to be spending the night at least.
Well, the two main questions I have is, am I going to be able to attend church tomorrow? And am I going to be able to go back to work on Monday?
You're not going to be going to church tomorrow.
Okay. I can live with that.
I don't know about work. That's going to depend on when you're arraigned and when your bail's set.
Mm-hmm.
So I can't make any promises on that.
Okay.
That's an unknown right now.
One of my most important questions. I know I did something wrong. Okay, I admit that.
You admit that you came to see a 13-year-old and have sex with them.
Yeah. And I feel bad about it. I can't explain it, but I know I did something wrong. And what I'm driving at is, is my sister going to be notified about this?
Not unless you tell her.
Okay, so you have no reason to bring my sister into this
now,
situation.
We'd like to take a look at your computer if you wanted to give us consent to do that.
Does it have to be at the residence, or can I bring it somewhere for you guys to do what
you're
going to
be in jail. So, you know, we would have to be able to get access to that computer. You know, are you the only one that uses the computer? Or does your sister use it as well?
No, that computer is mine. She has her own.
And it's in your room?
Yeah.
On the basement level of the house?
Mm-hmm.
And you say she has a computer?
She has her own laptop that she uses.
A laptop?
Yeah.
And where does she keep it?
On the main floor, either in her office or out in the living room.
Okay.
What I was driving at is it seems that she is going to find out, because if you have to have access to the computer, you have to go to the residence to do it.
Right. Well, there's different ways to deal with this. And, I mean, if you want to cooperate, you know, and give us consent to look at your computer, you know, we'll gladly take your consent to do so.
Mm-hmm. I'm trying to kind of build my life back again. You know, I know this is a big setback.
Yeah, it's going to be tough for you. But you're doing the right thing.
But
you're facing it head on, and, you know, that's the way to deal
with things. What I'm wanting not to do is have to explain any of this to my sister. I'm not trying to keep anything from her, but I'm trying to turn my life around. I'm trying to recuperate from my divorce and get on my feet financially and otherwise.
Mm-hmm. Why are you fearful for your sister to find out?
Well, I'm trying to, you know, I'm getting back into church, and she and I are bonding now, and we never did bond before.
Mm-hmm.
And we had a hard life, and I think I'm gonna lose her love and her trust if she finds out what I did and why I did it. That's kind of why I was.
You know, I can't promise you that she's not gonna find out. You know, that's a part of you having to deal with moving forward and dealing with that. I can't promise you.
Yeah, but like Agent Rita said early on, there's two routes you can come in here. You can sit here and tell us nothing and just be hardcore, or you can take the route you've taken and say, okay, I made a mistake. I can only go up now. And that's what you're doing. You're taking, you know, you're being open about it. And that's, to me, that means a lot. And, you know, you're heading straight forward. You're being upfront with us, and that's, you know, a lot of times we don't get that. That speaks volumes for you.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. And I know you're active in the church, and I know you want to get your life around. And it sounds like it looks some of it's worked for you. Because, I mean, you got in here and said this or that. But like Agent Reed says, we can't tell you that your sister's not gonna know. I mean,
she's obviously gonna find out when you don't come home that something's up.
Well,
she's gonna have questions for you.
She's
right.
She's busy this weekend. She's not expected home until sometime tomorrow afternoon. But
do you have any kids? Did I miss that earlier?
No.
So you don't have any children, does she?
No.
Okay. So, go ahead.
Well, as I said, she won't be scheduled home until tomorrow afternoon.
Mm-hmm.
And as you said, there's probably no way that she will not find out. I just don't know how I'm going to explain it.
Yeah.
You know, I can tell her I was arrested, and if she asks what for, I'm going to have to tell her the truth. I don't want to lie to
That's your call. That's your call, and you're going to have time to think about it before she gets back. You know, how you're going to deal with that.
Mm-hmm.
And did you have a cell phone or anything with you when you came?
No, I don't have a cell phone.
So you don't own a cell phone at all?
No.
And your PC down in the basement with you, that's the only PC. Is there another PC in the house?
Well, the other one's my sister's, but this is the only one I use.
Okay.
I don't.
So there's a laptop that she keeps upstairs.
She keeps upstairs, okay.
I only use my PC.
Now, is there a separate entrance to the basement that you use, or do you?
No, it goes up upstairs into the kitchen.
So you have to come in where to get to your
room? I come in through the garage.
Through the garage?
Into the kitchen and make a turn and go right downstairs.
Well, I guess the biggest thing is, I guess regarding the consent, I guess which way you're on, so we kind of know which way to go with you. I mean, if you feel like you want to consent to, regarding, you know, checking everything out, verifying everything, she has a form. It's up to you if you want to sign it or not. If you do, she'll have you sign it, you know, if you want to consent to. You have your computer and stuff checked out. If not, but that's up to you.
Okay. Is it gonna hurt my case if I refuse the consent?
No, it's your right.
It's your call.
It's your call.
I mean, consent. If you want to say no, it's not gonna change what we've talked about here. You've told me the truth. I'm cool with that. If you tell me no, I just take that blank paper back out the door. Or if you tell me yes, we'll sit here and we'll fill it out. You'll get to read it. You'll know exactly what it says, and you know everybody will feel good about it, and we'll have consent to look at the computer. I mean, that's your call.
I think I'm going to refuse the consent.
Okay. That's all comes about.
See, we're not tough guys. We just, and girls. We just want to find out what happened and, you know, go easy. Nobody's been mean to you or rude that I know of. So, not that this is a good experience for you, but I hope that you can.
I've learned it.
You can build off of it.
Yeah.
Adrian, I'll be stepping out. If you need anything, just let me know.
Okay, I'll be out in a few minutes. It's Westwood.
Mm-hmm. Another question I've got, and so I know what's going to happen. When all is said and done and all this is processed, am I going to lose my truck?
You know, they will...
Best way I can ask.
They will take your vehicle to a secure location. And at that point, you know, once you get out of jail, you can make arrangements to see what the plan is with your vehicle. I'm not sure at this point how that will be addressed. Mm-hmm. But once you get out of jail, you can ask them about your vehicle, and they'll give you that information freely. Okay?
All
right. And you go by Paul, you said, on MySpace, right? Do you use any other nicknames or alias?
No, just Paul.
Okay. And can you give me your address one more time? Phone number. Okay, and that emergency phone number. Okay. You're a non-resident of Kentucky. Marital status?
Separated.
Hey, is the information on your ID here, height, weight, all that correct?
No, I'm
height, 5'10"?
5'10", and I weigh with 216.
Hair color brown. And eye color hazel. Social Security number. And where are you employed? And that's where?
Westchester.
Is that one word or two?
Two.
Ohio.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Do you ever use a computer there?
No.
And so you gave them your vehicle information as well, right?
Yeah.
What shift do you work at the distribution?
Second.
1987. Okay, let me go and get all this other stuff together. You said you wanted some water. Let's see if I can get that out for you. Okay, be just a few minutes, okay?
Mm-hmm.
You said you wanted a water?
Yes. Thank you. Mm-hmm.
I another job.
I
You doing all right?
As best as I can be.
Pardon?
As good as I can be.
Yeah, it's not a good situation.
Yeah, plus I'm exhausted.
Yeah. Well, I almost finished up with the paperwork here, and then I'll call the jail to have somebody transport you. So it shouldn't be a whole lot longer. So you just sit tight.
Okay.
Yeah.
There's nothing going to be done about this until Monday?
Most likely it'll be Monday or after. I can't tell you when the judge will hear the arraignment.
So I'll be sitting in jail all day tomorrow?
Most likely, yeah.
Okay. In situations like this, it's you don't release I'm not saying on good behavior, but you don't write a summons and...
Do you have other past offenses?
No.
Okay. Well, I mean, with the judge, that's going to look good for you if you don't have any previous offenses on your record. So, I mean, there are some things in your favor. Do you have any traffic violations? Anything like that?
I might.
That's going to make you...
A ticket here and there, but nothing like this.
So, you've never been convicted of a crime?
No.
Okay. Well, I mean, that's most likely going to work in your favor. I don't know that you would be released on your own recognizance, but that would be for a judge to decide. You know, sounds like you got some stuff going for you. You've cooperated with us here. You know, you got some arguments that you can make, I'm sure. Okay?
Okay.
Any other questions?
Do you know how much longer it'll be?
Well, I'm hoping not long. I was just making a copy of the citation and getting ready to call the jail to send somebody over for you.
All right.
So,
What can I do about making... I'm not worried about the phone call for tomorrow, but I'm worried about how I'm going to contact my boss at work.
That's something you'll have to make arrangements through the jail. Okay. To make phone calls.
Can I talk to them tonight about it?
The jail?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, the officers that transport you, if they're from the jail, you could probably ask them. They may be able to tell you something.
All right.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Everything good?
Well, it's hard to tell right now.
Okay. But I mean, you're okay.
Yeah.
All right. We're getting ready to take you in just a second, okay? All right, Mr. Westwood, ready to go?
Yes.
Go ahead and stand up.
Can I take this with me?
Yeah, you're going to step outside this room here, and they're going to get you ready to go.
Will I be able to use the restroom somewhere?
They'll take care of that whenever you get to the jail. Unless you need it. Don't know. Do you need to use the restroom now?
Do you use the restroom?